Have you ever wondered where this thingamajig comes from? It's on all the plastic parts which are around us, on this pan, on both sides, on this plastic box. And it always looks as if something has been broken off. And that's the case. If you want to find out more, stay tuned and let's go to the clean room. Okay, now we are in the clean room. Let's enter the micro-injection molding. This is one of our micro-injection molding machines, and in principle, it's a standard machine. We use it to produce extremely small and precise parts with an accuracy of better than 1 micrometer. First of all, we need the raw material. It's a thermoplastic polymer like that, and this polymer is inserted into the machine over there. Then it is heated up and molten so it gets liquid, and after that, it is injected into the mold. The second part is the mold. It consists of 2 sides, which are ultra-precision machined, and they are pressed together with a force of 3 tons. And then the material solidifies, and after that, we have the part. Thank you very much. As you can see, this is the final product. What do we need from this product? This is the channel where the liquid polymer was inserted. But here, up in the front, this is our high-precision collimator array, POB. So we clip off the sprue, and where I cut off is where the thingamajig is. As we are doing micro-injection molding, the thingamajig is also micro. So let's have a look with a microscope. By the way, the thingamajig in reality is called gate mark. I hope you learned something today. Please leave a comment, and if you're interested in further videos, stay tuned.